Good evening everyone. I am Prakhar Gupta, member of Team Helios. Today I am going to show you how you can run our model on your PC. So let's get started. The link which we provide to you is a GitHub link of Harshit Batra, our team leader. He has uploaded all the files in his GitHub. When you open the link, it will open like this, on a page like this. It contains three folders and one IPNV file. The first the folder is real, forge and training. It contains the trained images features. It contains the data set that is forged images, and real it contains the genuine images. The image format is of XXX, YYY and ZZZ. Let's see like this. Total we have 60 images. 5 images of each person, so total we have 12 persons here. So if the images have a format of XXX, YYY, so if X equals to Y, it means the image is genuine. And if here let's see that X not equals to Y, here it is 021 and Y is 001, so X not equals to Y means image is forged. So to begin, how you can run our model in your computer. First, you go to clone on download, download the zip file. Let's wait for file to be downloaded. The file is downloaded. Now extract this folder to the place where you want to keep the file. I am keeping it on a desktop. Now I think the folder has been extracted. See, this is a folder. It contains all the three folders: forged, real and training. Let's see, these are the forged images, these are the real images, and this is the Axis Bank IPNV file. So it contains all the our model. So to run this file, first open CMD, then type Jupyter Notebook. This will open the Jupyter Notebook in your computer like this. Since I have already downloaded the file and keep in my computer, and I have keep the folder in the this folder, Axis Bank folder, that is axisbank.ipnb file. So open this. I have already opened this file. So this is our model. So let's get to know about our model, how we have done it. These are the libraries which we have imported to make our model. Then we defined the path for our images. So this is a genuine image path, means the real folder path. And this is the forged image path, the path for our folder which contains the forged images. Then for pre-processing of images to take out the features. So first we convert the RGB image into grayscale, then convert the grayscale into binary by using the blur radius of 0.08, which means the blur will be minimized or the noise will be minimized. Then we call the pre-processing. This function is calling all the our function, defined function, that is first images read from the path, then it will convert it into gray from RGB, then it will convert it into binary, and it will return the binary image. Then there are the functions we defined for feature extraction, that is ratio, centroid, eccentricity, solidity, skewness and kurtosis. Here is the function which calls all the our function to get the features. And for saving the features, we have one we have made a function called get CSV features, which first we will save all the features of a image in a CSV file, and this feature function will help to retrieve that feature from the CSV file. That is make CSV. Make CSV mean here the path has been provided. So if you want to run all the model in your computer, you have to change the path. Starting from here, I have given the path of the real folder. You have to give the path where you have stored your real folder. Again, for same for the first folder. Then changing all the paths here also. So this function, as I told you, is used to make the CSV. It will since when the image is given, it will extract the features and store the features of image in a CSV file. So the path where the CSV file is stored is given here. Let's say this is if in a data set, in a features data set, feature folder. So if it is not built, then the new folder will be created named features. And in the features, a training folder will be created if not built. And then all the features will be stored with a person ID given. See the person ID. Now we will write all these features in the CSV file. This is for the training set. Same goes for the testing set. Testing set means the image which we pass for the test. Then you call the make CSV. It will save the features for all the 12. So let's start it running the files. First, select this cell and type Control plus Enter to run the cell. The star shows the cell is running. So let's wait for the cell to complete its run. Then we run the next cell. Then this one. Since see the number is changing, this number is changing, it means the this cell is not run yet. After running, it will come, six number will come here. It means the cell is running. See, 7 will come here, 8, this, similarly this. Run all the cells, make CSV. After make CSV, call make CSV. So it will save all the features for the person ID 1, and it will save for all the person from ID 001 to 00010 012, that is 12th person. Let's wait since the features has been saving. Now the cell has completed its running. It means the feature for all the 12 person has been saved in a CSV file. You can check it by opening the CSV file saved in this path. The path is in my computer, the path is faccessbank data set features training data training and training underscore 00 or the person ID which will be given. So let's open the folder files access data set features training and see all the CSV files. So training underscore 00 month means it contains all the features of the images for the person ID 1. Let's open and see how it stores the features. So it stores the features, the ratio, the percent X, percent Y, electricity, eccentricity, skewness X in both the terms of X and Y, kurtosis in both the terms of X and Y, and the output given. Now come back to our model. So after this model is created, now we have built our model, the basic model. So in this cell, we have made our model. The input, this function is read CSV. Read CSV will read the training data from the CSV file in which features has been stored for the training set. Same goes for the test set. Here we are starting with our model creation, that is TensorFlow model or neural network model. We have the model our consists of three layers and one output layer. Since the last layer will tell the image is either genuine or forged, so it will give only two output. Here we have created our model layer 1, layer 2, layer 3 and the output layer. Then this function is a evaluate function. In this function we will pass the image, the test path and a train path. The test path consists of the image which we want to test. It will call the evaluate function will call the accuracy, find the accuracy, and the prediction of the image will provide an array which consists of two columns. The first column consists of an confidence against the genuine, and second consists of the confidence score again of confidence against false. So if first column value is greater than second, then the image is genuine, otherwise the image is false. So let's test. First give the person ID of the image whom we are to test, like person ID v1. I have already selected six images, three real and three false, for testing. So now the path is 001001_0001.png. Now see, the starting three digit and the next three digit are same, which means 001 and 001. So that is, it means the image is real and genuine. So let's run this. Now the output has come. So it tells the genuine image and true. Yes, the output was correct. It has to be a genuine image since the starting three terms and the next three terms of the image is same. Now I'll check the another. This time check the forged image for the ID person 001. The image we providing is 021001_0000.png. Now you can see, since the first three and the last second three are not same, it's 021 and 001, it's not same, it means the image is false. So let's check it out whether it gives the output as expected or not. So as expected, it gives the output forged image and false. It has to be forged image because the starting and the last were not same. Then check for another person. Let's this time check for 006, ID person 006. And the image which we provide is 006 underscore 000. from the path name or from the image name only. You can see the image is to be a genuine one since the first three and next three are same. So let's check it out. Is it really same or not? Wait for a few seconds. Wait for the output. The output has come. As expected, it is showing the genuine images and it has to be genuine. From the name itself, you can understand. Now check another one. This time check the forged image 006, 021, 006, underscore 001.png file. Now check this one. As expected, before coming of the output, you can expect the output to be a forged image because the first three and the next three are not same. So it's going to be a forced image for sure. As expected, it's come out to be a forced image. Now check for the another person. This time for the last one, 012, that is 12th person. And this time we will checking 012 underscore 005.png. Before coming, the output has come. It's a genuine image and it has to be genuine because the first three and the next three are same. So I hope you understand how you can run our model in your computer. Thank you for your time.